once in a while we hear these stories about music memorabilia selling for ridiculous amounts of money. Remember, we just heard that Kurt Cobain's guitar just went for $6 million?
Mm-hmm.
You know, the guitar that he used, I think it was in...
Unplugged,
yeah, in that famous, you know, Unplugged video and subsequent album. Well, now, today we're hearing that Elvis Presley's guitars just sold at auction for $1.32 million.
See, I don't understand that. You're going to put that on your wall at home, and when people come over, you're going to say, that's Elvis's guitar?
Yeah, and it's the guitar that he used to record this song, That's All Right, Mama. And I guess if you're a huge Elvis fan, that's a big win.
I know, but I can take any guitar and say this is Elvis's guitar.
No, not really. That it has to be authenticated. You know, there has to be pictures of him holding it, video of him using it. Sometimes the guitars get signed later on. Sometimes they've done DNA tests on some of these pieces of material, whatever, to see if it actually was. Like, just recently, a ripped poster of ZZ Top actually sold for a significant amount of money.
Why would that sell for any money? No, they're still alive.
It's no brainer for me. I met ZZ Top in 89 on their Eliminator tour. Got a full-size signed poster by all three of the gentlemen. The coolest dudes I ever met, but they're small. They're little guys.
So he got a signed poster. So that could sell. That's potentially something that could sell.
But they're alive. You can get any poster signed by them.
You could probably call them and be like, hi, I'll be right over.
Right. You can just knock on their door. Hey, will you sign this and get your brother to sign this too?
Right.
Here's $10.
Did you keep ticket stubs? Do you have autographs? Do you have any collectible and memorabilia from music?
What I did when I was in the music business is every band that I met, I had them sign something to my son.
Oh, it's so nice.
So like Uncle Cracker signed stuff. Matchbox 20 did this whole painting for him. Also got Kid Rock to sign a bunch of American flags and had them mounted and framed. So I kept one of those. I got tons of signed guitars. Yeah, tons of stuff.
Yeah, I only got one thing. And you know, it's so funny. I've been in the music industry probably as long as you have, but I've taken pictures with people, but I never said, hey, could you sign this? I never thought about stuff like that. So the only piece of music memorabilia that I have a mint condition copy of Madonna's Sex Book.
Mm-hmm.
I never opened it. It's still in the original Mylar that has the silk screen picture of her on it. Never opened it. And I have it wrapped in like lots of plastic and bubble wrap and stuff like that.
So it's not signed?
No.
It's just her book?
Yeah, but maybe eventually I'll meet her and have it signed. I don't know. Does it have to be signed? Can I just have the book?
I guess, but I mean, I'm pretty sure you can get that on eBay for $3-4.
Really? I didn't think that book. I figured it was a limited edition of those books that came out. I bought it for $50. I heard it was worth like $500 now. Is that not true?
I think somebody scammed you.
Oh.
Okay. Here's her sex book for $54.
Okay. I spend $50 on it, so I make a profit right there.
All right. Mylar cover, $25.
Just the Mylar cover is $25.
Yeah. Okay. Here's one. The French edition with CD. Do you have the CD?
No.
Yeah. $149.
Okay. That's not very much.
Yeah. With the CD. So you don't have the CD.
No. I don't have the CD. So mine's not French.
They have you beat. See, all of these have CDs sealed, $225, but it's got the CD.
Oh. Did it come with a CD or you got to buy it with a CD?
I guess. I don't know. Oh.
I just bought the book.
Yeah, I don't think it's worth as much as you think.
Yeah, I guess not. I was kind of hoping. It was my one piece of memorabilia. And the crazy thing is, I don't even really like Madonna.
Right. So why did you buy it? Just because you thought it was...
For an investment. No, because someone said to me, because they were selling it in only two places in New York City, and one of them was around the corner from my apartment.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody said, get online, go buy yourself a copy. It's going to be worth something someday. And it was only one per customer. So I got on the line and I waited and I spent $50 I didn't have. And I bought the book and I've been dragging it with me from apartment to apartment all these years.
It's probably in your storage unit. It's the only thing in your storage unit.
No, it's here. I have it here. I know where it is. But okay. The fact is I've just been dragging it with me all these years, hoping that one day it'll be worth something.
One day I'm going to retire with this book. One day. This is my retirement, damn it.
Listen, you just told me that somebody's offering $54. That's a $4 profit right there.
Yeah, but that has the CD. You don't have the CD. So you actually lost money.
I've lost money.